As we reported earlier, defense and economic cooperation took center stage during the address of Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida at the Philippine Congress. Let's get more details from our correspondent RG Cruz. RG.
Yes, Japanese Prime Minister Kishida Fumio reaffirmed his commitment to defend freedom and the rule of law at all costs, citing that the international order based on the rule of law is under serious threat. Kishida likewise announced the grant of security hardware to the Philippines during his speech to Philippine lawmakers. The Prime Minister noted that in the South China Sea, the trilateral cooperation of his country, the Philippines, and the U.S. to protect the freedom of the sea is underway. His visit and remarks come as China continues to insist on its ownership of the South China Sea, despite losing an arbitration case to the Philippines. China also has border disputes with Japan in the Senkaku Islands. Likewise, the Prime Minister reaffirmed before lawmakers his shared commitment with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to work together to maintain and strengthen the free and open international order based on the rule of law. The Prime Minister also explained that under his plan for a free and open Indo-Pacific is to defend freedom and rule of law at all costs. It was under this this plan that Japan provided 12 ships to the Coast Guard to improve the Philippines' maritime security capability, while a Japanese firm delivered a warning and control radar to the Philippine Air Force last month to improve air domain awareness. The Prime Minister also announced that Japan agreed with the Philippines to provide coastal surveillance radars to the Philippine Navy as the first cooperation project in the world under Japan's newly established official security assistance this year. The Prime Minister also bared plans to commence formal negotiations on a Japan-Philippines reciprocal access agreement which seeks to deepen strategic cooperation with the Philippines in the future. Back to you there.
RG Cruz reporting live. Thank you very much. Japan vows to further deepen its defense and economic ties with the Philippines. Speaking at a special joint session of the Philippine Congress Saturday, Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida said the relationship between the two countries is stronger than ever. The Japanese leader also reaffirmed his country's commitment to defend the Indo-Pacific region amid growing maritime tensions in the area.
The relationship between Japan and the Philippines has made great strides over the past half century. I believe that the people-to-people connection is a bedrock of this relationship.
From this standpoint, I confirmed with President Marcos during his visit to Japan in February that we would work together to maintain and strengthen the free and open international order based on the rule of law.
In the South China Sea, the trilateral cooperation to protect the freedom of the sea is underway. Through these efforts, let us protect the maritime order, which is governed by laws and rules, not by force.
Kishida is the sixth head of state and the first Japanese premier to address the Philippine Congress. The Philippines and Japan agreed to kickstart negotiations on a reciprocal troop access deal during the visit of Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. This pact would follow a similar deal the Philippines has with the U.S. called the Visiting Forces Agreement. It essentially provides a legal framework for Washington's military presence in the Philippines. This development comes amid heightening tensions in the South China Sea, fueled by Beijing's increasing aggression in the disputed waters.
There was an exchange of notes on the official security assistance from Japan to the government of the Republic of the Philippines. This OSA will further enhance the military capacities of our countries, including the Philippines, which shares common security concerns with Japan. We are cognizant of the benefits of having this arrangement, both to our defense and military personnel, and to maintaining peace and stability in our region.
And also, we shared serious concerns about the situation in the East China Sea and the South China Sea, and that attempt to unilaterally change the status quo by force is unacceptable.
Japan and the Philippines have also inked several deals on the first day of Kishida's official visit. Among those signed include the official security assistance grant from Japan to the Philippines, amounting to more than 230 million pesos for the coastal radar system. This system is seen to improve the Philippine Navy's maritime domain awareness. Memorandums of cooperation in the field of tourism and mining were also signed. The Philippine Coast Guard chief also scheduled to meet with his Japanese counterpart Saturday to discuss regional maritime challenges as well as issues in the West Philippine Sea. PCG Commandant Admiral Ronnie Gavan is expected to hold bilateral talks with JCG Commandant Admiral Shohei Ishii regarding the capability development and partnership between the two Coast Guards.
Alam mo naman ang bansang Japan ay isang aliadong bansa na matagal na nating katulong sa mga developments ng Philippine Coast Guard. Yung mga barko natin ay galing sa Japan, no? At ang mga radar system natin, at involved din sila sa human resource development ng Philippine Coast Guard. Bibigyan natin ng arrival honors ang Prime Minister ng Japan dito at may panandali ang pag-uusap kasama po ng mga leaders ng Philippine Coast Guard. At pagkatapos natin ay ituturo po natin siya sa isang barko ng Philippine Coast Guard na ginawa po sa bansang Japan.
Ishii is set to pay a courtesy visit at the PCG headquarters in Manila this morning, while Japanese Prime Minister Kishida will visit the headquarters later this afternoon before leaving for Malaysia. Japan and the Philippines' tourism sectors also getting a boost. The two countries signed a memorandum of cooperation for tourism, their first standalone cooperation agreement. Under this deal, both countries agreed to increase tourist arrivals as well as exchange information on matters related to the industry. Tokyo is one of Manila's top sources of visitors, with nearly a quarter million Japanese arrivals into the Philippines. A joint working group from the two countries' tourism departments is also set to convene for the implementation of the deal, which will run for 5 years and is subject to renewal. China denies having sleeper cells or agents working undercover in the Philippines. This comes after the arrest of heavily armed Chinese nationals in Pasig City. In a statement, the Chinese embassy slammed the allegations and lambasted Filipino officials for disseminating what it called highly irresponsible remarks against Chinese people. They add the allegations disrupt diplomatic efforts between the two countries. The embassy, however, notes it has taken note of the case involving the armed Chinese nationals and is now working with Philippine authorities. A Philippine industry group urges newly appointed Agriculture Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel Jr. to look into the organizational infrastructure of the agency. According to Philippine Chamber of Agriculture and Food President Danilo Fausto, the successful implementation of the department's programs also relies on the officers in charge of them. He adds there must be a huge change to revive the agriculture industry.
Ang dami ng problema, sabay-sabay, eh, no? Mm-hmm. Livestock, poultry, dairy, crop, fishery sector, lahat sabay-sabay. Eh. Kaya kailangan yung mga delegation, yung authority, kailangan magaling yung mga magpapatakbo.
Motorists are in for another oil price rollback next week. Estimates show a liter of diesel could be cheaper by up to 1 peso and 20 centavos, while a liter of gasoline could go down by up to 60 centavos. As for kerosene, prices are expected to dip by at least 80 centavos.